Alhamdulillah, I look forward to tomorrow and the day after, inshallah. So again, a little more enthusiastically. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Alhamdulillahi wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillahi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala. All praise belong to Allah. We ask Him to shower His peace, blessings and mercy upon our dear and beloved Prophet Muhammad, his family, his companions, followers, and upon us through His mercy and grace. Ameen.
Ameen.
Let us review our dua. And in our review, it's not just for memorization purposes, it's for all we can actually make the dua that Allah accepts. So say it sincerely.
Allahumma ihdina fi man hadayt, وعافنا في من عافيت وتولنا في من توليت وبارك لنا فيما أعطيت وقنا واصرف عنا برحمتك شر ما قضيت إنك تقضي بالحق ولا يقضى عليك إنه لا يذل من واليت ولا يعز من عاديت تباركت ربنا وتعاليت نستغفرك اللهم ونتوب إليك.
May Allah accept our dua.
Ameen.
And our prayers.
Ameen.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our dua.
Ameen.
That being said, we are reciting, mashallah, the 17th juz, and we have one page left in Surah Al-Anbiya. عليهم جميعا وعلى نبينا أفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم. This is one of the most beautiful surahs. Every surah, if you just immerse yourself in it, you'll really enjoy its sweetness and the countless blessings and lessons that we can learn from it. Surah Al-Anbiya. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks in Surah Al-Anbiya in many places, starting with the story of Musa alayhi salam briefly. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا مُوسَى وَهَارُونَ الْفُرْقَانَ وَضِيَاءً وَذِكْرًا لِلْمُتَّقِينَ الَّذِينَ يَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَيْبِ وَهُمْ مِنَ السَّاعَةِ مُشْفِقُونَ. Then Allah goes to the story of Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا إِبْرَاهِيمَ رُشْدَهُ مِنْ قَبْلُ. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala moves to the story of Sayyidina Ishaq and Ya'qub. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَوَهَبْنَا لَهُ إِسْحَاقَ وَيَعْقُوبَ نَافِلَةً. And then Allah goes to the story of Sayyidina Lut. وَلُوطًا آتَيْنَاهُ حُكْمًا وَعِلْمًا. And then Allah moves to the قصة سيدنا نوح. وَنُوحًا إِذْ نَادَى مِنْ قَبْلِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala goes on to the story of Sayyidina Dawood and Sulaiman, father and son. May Allah make you like Dawood and Sulaiman in righteousness.
Ameen.
And may Allah provide you like Dawood and Sulaiman. You can't get exactly like them, but maybe a little less. They were prophet kings. And they had many amazing things. I think the youth would really enjoy the story of Sulaiman and Dawood. It isn't my topic tonight, but just to touch base on it briefly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَسَخَّرْنَا مَعَ دَاوُودَ الْجِبَالَ يُسَبِّحْنَا وَالطَّيْرَ وَكُنَّا فَاعِلِينَ.
For those who doubt, Allah says, and we made the mountains and the birds do tasbih, glorification of Allah with Dawood. And we truly did so. Ajeeb, imagine your child, they like dinosaurs, they like little toys. Imagine when you tell them not fiction, not Transformers, no offense to Transformers, I like watching the movies, but the actual real stories in the Quran about mountains responding in tasbih with a prophet and birds responding in tasbih, joining a prophet, Dawood alayhi salam, whom Allah gave one of the most, if not the most beautiful voice. Ajeeb, imagine most beautiful voice, birds and mountains responding in tasbih with you. And then not only that, Allah blessed him with a son who had much more. They were taught, وَعُلِّمْنَا مَنْطِقَ الطَّيْرِ. We're going to read that thing in 2 days, inshallah. They were given the language of birds. Can you imagine communicating with birds? And then he also was given the communication of ants, when he heard the ants speak. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him control over the wind. Wind! You know how airplanes and turbines, and they move and they kind of, yeah, those who work at GE, so it moves you up? He had control over that before they invented planes. Allah made that amr وَسَخَّرْنَا لَهُ الرِّيحَ تَجْرِي بِأَمْرِهِ رُخَاءً حَيْثُ أَصَابَ. Allah says that. He commanded the wind for Sulaiman. And then not only that, he also commanded the jinns to go and go undersea and get him all the different gems and jewels. Ajib, you go to one of the stores and you have to pay 30,000 plus for a diamond. He had diamonds coming to him all the time and all sorts of gems. SubhanAllah. Amazing. If you share these stories with your children, first we have to learn them, to give them, right? So maybe you should grab the Mus'haf and read Surah Al-Anbiya and then go read Qasas al-Nabiyyin and see something that is beneficial, not only for your child, benefit them in their imagination and deen, but also benefits them in the akhirah as well. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gave them good judgment. May Allah give us good judgment. Ayyub. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the story of Sayyidina Ayyub alayhi salam. And in it is an example for all those who, the worshippers, those who worship Allah. May Allah make us sincere worshippers.
Ameen.
When Ayyub called upon his Lord. So whenever you are going through a hardship, call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He needs no appointment. He needs no time. He needs no line to stand in line for. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala needs no someone, no nobody to have a connection with him or you know them to help you get to him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ever there. Ayyub alayhi salam was tested. And he was tested in his health. For those of us who get a little cough and we start panicking, he was bedbound. For those who are sick and bedbound among in our community, may Allah give them shifa. And then he lost all of his wealth. He couldn't go to work. All of us are vulnerable to that. May Allah protect us and preserve our health. Imagine, tomorrow something, God forbid, we can't go to work anymore. We can't go to our practices. We can't go to our jobs. That could happen. We take every day for granted. That's why we should make the morning dua and thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for everything that He blesses us with. So Allah took away his wealth. Allah took away his health. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took away his children. The roof collapsed. All of his children died. I can't say what a test. What tests? Imagine, think about your child, may Allah preserve him or her and all of them, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not test you with one, Allah tested him with all of them. At once. Do you know what he said when he was laying in bed with no money and no children? Hardship has fallen upon me, and you are the most merciful. Do you understand linguistically? Everything good or bad happens from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the prophets, why they're praised, why they're the best of human beings, the adab. The adab he had when he's attributing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he chose not to attribute hardship out of adab and respect. He said, hardship fell upon me. He didn't say, you have put hardship upon me. And then he says, and you are the most merciful. We are immersed in the blessings of Allah. We have fancy air-conditioned cars, air-conditioned homes, air-conditioned masjid, beautiful clothes that are about to be air-conditioned. And we're sitting here, and we are, some of us complaining, the weather is too cold 2 days ago. It's raining too much. We cannot. Accept that. Wallahi, if we don't start counting our blessings and thinking about our blessings, we are at risk for those blessings to be stripped away from us.